morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sit down.
Thank you, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm fine, ma'am.
Have you seen animals?
Yes, ma'am.
Where have you seen them?
Zoo.
Zoo.
Okay, and what about your own home? Do you have pets?
Yes.
Who all have pets? Raise your hands, those children who are having pets. You have a pet? What pet animal you have?
Cat.
Cat. Very good. Sit down. Who else? Goat. He has got a goat. What about you, Afifur Rahman?
Rabbit.
He has got a rabbit. Yes?
Bird.
Bird. You have a bird. Sit down. Yes, Fatima?
Fish.
You have fish. Sit down. Yes, Nida?
Parrot.
You have parrot. Okay. Can you divide these animals into two groups?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Manal?
Wild animals and domestic animals.
Very good. Clap for Manal. We can divide the animals between two groups, wild and domestic. Now, what are wild animals? Can you keep a wild animal as your pet?
No, ma'am.
Why? Any idea? Yes, Nida?
They will eat
what?
Ma'am.
Yes?
They will eat me.
Okay, they will eat you. Okay. Yes, we cannot keep wild. Yes, beta? Stand up.
Ma'am, because they are danger.
They are danger or they are dangerous?
Dangerous.
Yes, sit down. Yes, they are dangerous. They can kill us. That is why we cannot keep wild animals. And even the government has made strict laws that people cannot keep wild animals at home. And what about the animals which give us milk? Can you name them? Wait. Yes, Mishkar? Be loud. Yes. Cow, goat, buffalo. What else? Very good, very good. Sit down. So all these animals gives us milk. Today we'll be learning about a poem about the cow. Okay. This poem is written by Robert Louis Stevenson, a very great English poet. He has written a lot of poetry, especially for children. Okay. Now open your books, page number 71. Open it. Has everybody opened the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now pay attention, look into the first stanza. The friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders loving, lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day, and blown by all the winds that pass, and wet with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers. So this is a poem about a loving and friendly cow. Now who wants to read it? Raise your hands. Yes, Zufishan, stand up. Hold your book in your hand.
The friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stay. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day, and blew by all the winds that pass, and wet with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eat the meadow flowers.
Sit down. Now who wants to read?
Manal.
Yes, Manal.
The cow, the friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, all pleasant light of day, the blowing by all the wind that pass, and yet with all the showers. She walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers.
Okay, Nita Hassan, stand up.
Cow, the friendly cow, old and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders, lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day, and blown by all the winds that pass, and with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers.
The friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day, and blown by all the winds that pass, and wet with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers. Now I want all of you to read from your book. Now take out your notebooks, write down the name of the poem. Now I'm writing the new words which have come in this poem, and you people first have to pronounce the words, and then you will be writing in your notebooks. Quickly write down, just write down two words from the first stanza which are new for you. And those who have written these words, please raise your hands. Now I'm pronouncing the words, and then you people have to repeat, all of you together. M-I-G-H-T, might. Once more.
M-I-G-H-T, might.
Okay. A-P-P-L-E, apple.
A-P-P-L-E, apple.
T-A-R-T,
tart. T-A-R-T, tart.
Now. Yes.
Apple.
Have you people ever heard of this word, might?
Ma'am.
Power.
Yes. This means? Power. This is a completely a new word for all of you, but you are familiar with the meaning. What is the meaning of might?
Power.
And can you make a sentence on might?
Ma'am.
Yes, Nida, stand up. Yes, Nida.
I drag the chair of my might.
No, it's not correct. I drag the chair off my might.
Ma'am, please.
Yes.
My friend is very mighty.
It's not might, it will be mighty. My friend is mighty. That means it's powerful.
Ma'am.
Yes? You want to say something?
Ma'am. My brother drags the table on her might.
Her?
Ma'am.
You'll be using her for your brother?
Ma'am, please.
Ma'am.
No, beta. I'm saying you'll be using her for your brother?
Ma'am.
Or his?
His.
Then complete your sentence.
Ma'am.
My brother drags the table with
with all his might.
Yes, very good. Now who wants to try? Yes, Vanya, stand up. Be loud.
I drag the table with all my might.
Very good. Clap for Vanya. Now write down this meaning in your notebook also. Have you written?
Yes.
Have you written, Yusra?
Yes, ma'am.
See, everybody look here. There is a picture. This man is showing his muscles. He's trying to project his power. This picture, actually, you cannot say that this is might. This is power. But this picture helps you understand the meaning of the word might. Okay, this man is showing his power. You always do with your friends, na? That I am so mighty, I am so powerful. You show your muscles. Is it clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you written?
Yes, ma'am.
Now coming to the next word, apple tart. Have you heard of this name?
Yes, ma'am.
What is apple tart?
Yes, sir.
Have you eaten a pastry ever?
Yes, ma'am.
You must have eaten, now all of you, pastry. So this is a dessert made of pastry and apple. Apple, you know, this apple is a fruit. Everybody knows apple is a fruit, and we use apple. And what is the difference between desert and dessert? Now, what is the spelling for desert? You have just said D-E-S-S-E-R-T, dessert. And there is another thing you can see on the, everybody look at the board, D-E-S-E-R-T, desert. Now these are both the same thing, desert and desert. Then what is the difference? Only the spelling. Yes, beta, stand up.
Desert are sandy.
Yes, deserts are sandy places. Very good. And what is a dessert? Just now you have said that.
Made of pastry and apple.
That is the definition for apple tart. But what is the meaning of dessert?
A sweet thing.
Yes. After every meal, after dinner or lunch, we eat sweet things. Like a chocolate or a kheer or a firni or whatever. That all these things are dessert. And dessert, D-E-S-E-R-T. Is a hot and sandy, dry place. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll give you time of 3 minutes, each one of you. And you people are divided already in three groups. Okay. Now you have read the poem. It is a poem, The Cow. First, we'll do the grammar portion of this poem and then I'll elaborate it. This is group one. This is group two. And this is group 3. Okay. This class is already divided into 3 groups.
Yes.
Now this is group 1, group 2 and group 3. I'll give you some time to decide among all of you. And then I'll be calling each one of you to write, come and write on the board. Okay. I'll be writing, this side will be telling, this group will be telling me naming words. The second group will be telling me action words. And the third group will be telling me describing words from this poem. Is it clear? You can discuss among your friends, your classmates, your partners, and then you raise your hands. Okay? 5 minutes time have been given to all of you. No, discuss first and then raise your hand. Yours is group 1, yours is group 2, and that is group 3. Is it clear? Don't raise your hands. 5 minutes time is still there for you. You can discuss among your friends and classmates. And then raise your hand. Okay, now time is over. From group 1, who will come and write down? And first tell me, what are naming words?
Nouns.
Yes, nouns are?
Naming words.
Now who will be coming and writing?
Ma'am.
Yusra, come. Come, quickly. Only one naming. Very good, Yusra. Very good. Now group 2. What are action words? Yes, action words are?
Verb.
Now who will come and write down the action word? Obed, come. Very good. Clap for Ubed. Now from this two, what are describing words? Very good. Adjectives. Now can you come and write down one describing word? Who will come? Fatima, come. All. Yes, it is an adjective. Now coming to group one. Zoya, you come. Is it wrong or right? Who's saying wrong? Why is it wrong? Yes, apple cart is a noun. They are naming words. Now, from this side. Yes, Aman, come. No, beta. No, this is your side, huh? Group 2. No, this is not an action word. Bad. Emma, come. Might is an action word?
Yes, Raj.
Yes, open is an action word. Now from that side, who is coming to write down the describing word? Yes, very good. Red and white are describing words. What are they?
Describing words.
Write down this in your notebook also. You're done? What about rest of you?
No.
Quickly do it. You have also done? Very good. You have done? Pay attention in the first paragraph. I'm just explaining you the first paragraph. The friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. Poet is very fond of this cow. Can you see the cow?
Yes, ma'am.
And who will tell me the color of this cow?
Red
and white. So, poet is very fond of this cow. He loves this cow from all his heart. Why does he love this cow? Because this cow gives milk, and that milk is used for making
cream.
And that cream is used with by this poet to eat. Have you seen an apple chart? See, beta, this is apple tart. They are in slices. It is made of bread. It is very sweet. Okay. And poet is using the cream to eat with this apple tart. So whenever you go to the market, visit a pastry shop or a cake shop and have it. It's very delicious. Fine. Now can you form a sentence on this?
Ma'am.
Apple tart.
Ma'am.
Yes, Vanya. Very good. Who else? Sit down, sit down, sit down. Yes?
I eat apple tart.
I eat apple tart, okay. What else? Yes, Zoya?
Apple tart is very delicious.
Yes. Very good. Clap for Zoya again, everybody. my mother is brought or my mother has brought. What better?
I will see the apple tart.
I will see your apple tart or I will eat. You will just see the apple tart.
Yesterday I
ate
apple tart.
I eat or I ate?
I ate.
Okay, fine. Thank
Tonight,
you.
Tonight I eat apple tart.
Tonight, what, repeat again.
Tonight I am eating apple tart.
Tonight I am eat or tonight I will be eating apple tart or I will eat apple tart. For future tense you have to use will. Okay. Now coming to the second stanza. She wanders lowing here and there and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day. Now poet is saying that she wanders lowing here and there. You know what is lowing? What is the sound of a cow? Mowing. Mowing? No, moo. Who can produce the sound?
Moo.
Huh? Yes. And she is roaming here and there. Have you ever visited a vegetable market?
Yes,
ma'am. Have you seen a cow over there?
Yes, ma'am.
How do they move?
Slowly.
In slow motion, okay. And which sound do they produce? And can anybody come and walk like a cow over here?
Ma'am.
With the sound?
Ma'am.
Yes, Aman? Yes, yes, come, come, come. Can you walk like a cow?
Ma'am.
No? Aise cow walk karta hai?
No, ma'am.
How does it walk?
Ma'am.
It walks straight like this?
Ma'am.
Or it bends like this and then walk? Yes, Riza, come. Okay, and what sound does it? No, just stand and move like that. Yes, and yes, good, stand up. And what sound does it produce? Ooh, yes, very good, go back. And blown by all the winds that pass and wet with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers. Have you ever seen a meadow? What is a meadow? What about this side?
A grass field
or a grassy field?
A
meadow is
a grassy field.
Look at this picture. This is a meadow. It is a grassy field. And that field has trees and have you ever seen a field? What is a field? Yes?
There are flowers and grass.
Okay, very good, Manal. Flowers and grass are there.
And there are trees. But there are trees.
Yes. Now look at this picture, everybody, carefully. This is a meadow. Yes, this is a meadow. It is a grassy field. She wanders in this meadow grass, walks slowly. She walks among the meadow grass, eats the meadow flowers, and blown by all the winds that pass and wet with all the shower. Though her grass gets wet with the showers. What are the showers? With which showers the grass is getting wet?
Ma'am, on the sky.
On the sky? No, from where the showers are coming? Your answer is right that showers are coming from the sky. But what do you call that, those showers? Yes, what is it called?
Rain.
Rain makes the grass wet, but still she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers. You can see in the picture, cow is eating meadow is eating a flower. It's in her mouth. You know what is the difference between strolling and walking? If I am walking like this, this is a walk, or this is a brisk walk, you can say. But strolling means to walk slowly. So cow walks like this. And she produces a sound of moo. Where does the cow wander? Who can answer this question?
The cow wander in the meadows.
Yes, cow wander in the meadow. Very good. And why does the poet love the cow? Yes, because cow gives milk with all her might, and that milk is used to make cream, and poet is very fond of eating apple tart. Okay, now once again look into your notebooks. The friendly cow, all red and white, I love with all my heart. She gives me cream with all her might to eat with apple tart. She wanders lowing here and there, and yet she cannot stray. All in the pleasant open air, the pleasant light of day. And blown by all the winds that pass and wet with all the showers, she walks among the meadow grass and eats the meadow flowers. Okay, this is a poem about a cow, and poet is very fond of this cow because the cow gives him milk, and that milk is used for making
cream.
And cream is eaten with
apple tart.
And the poet is telling us about the cow, that this cow wanders from here and there, from one meadow to another meadow, by producing that which sound of cow?
Moo.
Moo. Produce that sound and moo strolls from one meadow to another meadow. Okay.
Asta, I was watching your class. For me, you did justice to the poem and English language teaching and learning. Also, if you look at the point of view of language teaching and learning. So I would like to ask you some of the questions in the light of how you did in the classroom. Okay, you can just reflect on those things which I feel maybe useful for us to understand what went into your mind before you went into the class, then why you changed while teaching. Let me ask you the first question, and then in your warming up or brainstorming, whatever you call, you were able to ask children some questions, some activity you did, which children were able to talk, bring from their real life. What do you think that this is necessary, this will help? Please.
Yes, this would definitely help the children because this makes the teaching learning process interactive, as well as they'll develop interest because they get associated with their real life. The examples, we elicit examples from the students, and the examples are from their own experiences and lives. They get associated with the chapter well. And
fine. So you mean to say that a teacher has to connect the classroom
to the real life,
the real life.
Yes.
Children. That's fine. It's well taken. Yeah, probably it is a message from your lesson. We should say that. The second thing was you made children read. I think many children read after you have read the poem, the whole poem once, twice. Then you asked children, some were reading very well, some were really finding it difficult to do so. In such a situation, do you think that you should give importance to children who are not able to read well also? What do you think, sir?
Yes, of course, a teacher has to pay attention to those children who are not able to pronounce the words, or they are not able to recite the poem in the way it should be. And the practicing more will give the solution to the problem.
Fine. That means it also enables more participation from
children. Yes, student participation is must in the class.
Thank
you. Teacher giving a rote speech would not be a class interactive. It won't make an interactive class.
Fine. That's fine. The more children participate,
yes,
better the learning. Fine.
Yes.
The third thing which actually attracted my attention was, you didn't write when you wrote on the board, you didn't write or you didn't mention to the class nouns as nouns, verbs as verbs, adjectives as adjectives. You said naming words, action words, then describing words. So, and of course you did it at the end, what are they? Then why do you think that you have to use such functional terms like naming words, action words? Please.
Yes, I feel that a teacher should never teach grammar in isolation. It should always be associated with the literature portion or whatever she is teaching. And naming words and action words I have used because children are more familiarized with these words, these terms. We can elicit more and more examples from the students,
okay,
if we are using such words.
Exactly. Thank you for that, because if you say that noun denotes to the name of a person, nobody is going to understand that quote unquote definition.
Yeah.
Better to use them through action, through functions. Fine. I also would like to draw your attention, we have a poem now before us.
Yeah.
For example, the rhyming words and the rhyme scheme I don't know why you didn't draw the attention of children towards that. For example, the last word of the first line, friendly cow, all red and white, white. The third line, she gives me cream with all her might. The white, white and might, heart and dot. I expected you could have drawn their attention towards this rhyming scheme and rhyming words. You didn't do so. Did you deliberately not do that, or you thought that you will be dealing with that the next class?
That's what I thought, that I'll be doing it in the next class.
Fine.
Because according to the syllabus bifurcation and what I have planned for today is this lesson only.
Okay, fine. You are going to do it separately, probably in next class.
Yes.
Why?
Because this will help in reciting the poem in future also. Their reading skills will be developed in a better way. If they are reciting a poem, they should be aware of the rhyming words.
Exactly. Thank you, Asta.